Giants. I think they need him more than anyone else. Last in the major leagues in home runs last year. Obviously, you get Stanton, you can change that.
And I think unless the Dodgers do some maneuvering, he's not a fit there right now. His timing a couple of years ago would have been great for him. They're trying to get under the luxury tax. They've paid it five straight years. They've got five outfielders. They've got some money coming off the books next year, but it just seems like the timing isn't there.
I agree with you. And last week I was talking about, I just don't understand why players with no trade clauses don't agree to go to a winning team. And you think about the two teams that Jack just brought up, the San Francisco Giants, the St. Louis Cardinals. You feel really good about both of those organizations. The fan base is into it. They're going to do everything to try to win again. So I think both spots would be perfect for Stanton if he wants to go to a winning club. Obviously, San Francisco, a huge ballpark, doesn't really play into Stanton's game. He had 59 home runs. Huge ballpark doesn't mean a thing. He'll make it look small.
Yeah, in very small print, you look at the fact that he can opt out after 2020, but I don't think anybody in their right mind thinks that with 10 years and $295 million, he's going to do that, Jack.
Unless he hits 70 and then 75 and 80 home runs in the succeeding years, he's got a nice contract that the Marlins signed him to, the previous Marlins owners, and that's why the current Marlins owners, Bruce Sherman, Derek Jeter, they're trying to figure out a way to move their marquee player and maybe even trying to put a little pressure on him, Bob. There was some talk that the Marlins said, well, if you don't let us move you, we're going to move some of the other talented players around you, so this is going to be a barren desert and a difficult place for you to play. If I'm Giancarlo Stanton, I'd laugh at that from across the desk and say, okay, same thing, different season. That's what the situation has been there previously. They don't get people to show up for their games. They haven't been a winning franchise. So I think that that threat is a veiled threat. And if I'm Stanton, it wouldn't change what I was doing. I'd be patient and I'd enact that no trade clause on my timetable.
Yeah, I would think that that strategy would probably backfire, right? I mean, if I was Derek Jeter in the ownership group there, I would go to Stanton and say, you're the man. You hit 59 home runs. You're the MVP and you have no trade. What can we do to help you get to a situation you want to get to? Obviously, California is a big topic of conversation right here, but try to work together, right? Because obviously, ownership wants that contract off of the books. Stanton wants to play on a winning club. You should be able to make this deal happen.
You know, I think there's one school of thought, Jack, that says, well, it's his first big move. Jeter has to get this right. On the other hand, I look at it like he's already sent out enough smoke signals that they're moving Stanton if they can. So it's like the Miami fan base is already expecting it.
They're expecting it, and it's going to happen at some point. We know that they're going to move money. They've talked about how they're trying to get that payroll down from 140 to 90. This is an organization that has lost a lot of money. So what the new owners are trying to do is figure out a way to cut some costs and then help prop this organization up again. They're going to try and build with young talent. They're going to try and build through the draft. You look at the last two teams that have won World Series, the Chicago Cubs, the Houston Astros. What did both of them do? There was a lot of losing that preceded them getting back to the top. And how did they get back to the top? With draft picks. I think that's what the Marlins are trying to do. They've got a lot of work ahead of them. And this is the biggest domino, as I mentioned earlier, that has to fall first.
All right.